Yeah, I'm Dr. Mika Karaila, and so let's go straight to the presentation. So I have been prototyping and exploring this PADIM for a while. So the FDI is actually based on OPC-UA, and this field device information is then the PADIM node set. So it's actually the FDA first a little bit explained, but it's giving overview and background information for this. But as we have been talking, the standard information model for different field bus protocols is this that can be used with the large scale of devices. And UA expert can be used to demonstrate and explore. I have the demonstration about this. And then the FDI can be used to parameterize these field devices and also for the condition monitoring. And Frank Fengler from the APP was here 2019. And you can actually look a little bit what Frank was talking few years ago. And the disclaimer is this, that examples are prototypes that are used to explore PADIM and its use and maturity. So they are not yet the products. So this is the generated summary from the enterprise AI. What is this PADIM? But it aims to facilitate these information-driven systems that can offer increased connectivity, real-time data, and advanced analytics for process automation. That is the key point with this presentation. And it's the getting the information from the OPC Foundation, Fieldcom Group, and ISA organization. And this is the actually it's designed for understanding this semantic identification. So there's this manufacturer independent information model. Then it's actually reusing this DI model and the device asset that is asset management cell can use, but it also contains those functions and the process variables. And there is this the OPC-UA part 1000 or 100. I think it's 1000. I can't remember now. I have to check that before I give this presentation to out. And then there is the, this IEC specification, and it's using actually the IRDI model, the IRDI node set. And I have the detailed explanation how that is actually bind together. I had to actually little bit make the reverse engineering to find out how the dictionary entry is used. But I will explain it a little more detail. Then there is the signal variable type that is used part 8. And there is this the zero point adjustment, auto adjust positioner. There is a lot of the nice features added into this information model. And here is actually the simplified data access, what it provides, manufacturer independent, sorted, structured, priorized, and mapping can be understood by these standard interface tools. And NOAA was this Namur open architecture. It provides the syntax and semantics to contextualize the data points. And the IEC, this common data dictionary, is this IRDI node set. And next to this IRDI, so you can actually the IEC web pages, you can actually look the actual wall, and here is actually, this is the dictionary on the server, dictionaries on the server, this is the UA expert, and it's here the display name is this actual wall, and the node ID is actually this using the code that is actually, I have the zoomed version here, but the code is actually then this IEC specification code. And it's actually binding this the actual value and the, this dictionary that is has dictionary entry in the variable that you are using. So that is actually explaining how the IRDI node set is bind into the PIDIM. But that is the key point here. And the sensor type is one good example. The device itself uses a less memory and very packed. So you have here actually the sensor type as a number. You don't know what that number will mean, but then you have here on the value as text and the enumeration values contains all the possibilities what the sensor type can be. I will demonstrate this later. But this is one good example that you can get also the into the user interface the sensor type as a readable text this way. And then as you change this, it will update the value. What is the real sensor type? Is it the PT100, PT2000, PT1000? Yeah. And then this is also that you have here this the hash dictionary entry tag. And if you look what the reference is actually going, it will go to this dictionary. And there you can find the node ID that contains the code to IEC specification. But that makes it exactly same globally. That is the reason give the semantics here. That is very, very specific way to do it. Okay. Then we will go a little bit what I have been prototyping in with Valmet system. So this demo server actually contains now the network set. So I'm actually scanning our network, the DNA network. I will find the controllers. I will find different field buses. From the field bus, I can find different sensors. And from the sensors, I will actually convert those during the runtime to devices. So I have then the standard information model for each device that we have connected into our system. This is our own IQ frame system device. And then I can also have the other devices here. I have here the heart devices connected, and it actually gives those the network set, the field bus, the IO rack, the IO card, and then it will go to channel level that contains the heart modem, and then you have these devices here. And you have here all these the device manual hardware revision model serial number. Most of the data can be actually read directly from the our sensors in the DNA. So there is actually the one proposal that the PADIM should contain. Now I have actually made the display name so that it will order these to meaningful order. So Matias, this should be added to specification, some extension that we can use also some attribute in the node set that will give the order or how to organize the all the parameters, because it's now using the display name and the alphabetic order. So I made the number and then the capital letters to get the order meaningful.
I think there's a dedicated reference type.
Okay, nice. I have to then fix my prototype. And then I have actually the extended this also a little bit. So I actually made this here that I can use the heart command 48 to get vendor specific status information. I think it's the somehow clever implementation, but I was just experimenting how to do it. So I added the method, the get diagnostics, and it will get the heart reply, then the byte string here. I have added also how to translate the bytes and bits to meaningful explanation descriptions. Okay. Then I think I will have time for a little demo. Okay. Oh, now I have to duplicate this just a moment. Yep. So now I have the small demo server. So it contains now the heart device information here. Then these primary value, secondary value, third and fourth value are here, and all the other diagnostics information, what you can actually read with the common data, common commands with the heart, and then I have some our metadata also added here. But you have actually here different sensors, and this is for the CIMO code, and then some other data, and this was the sensor type that I was demonstrating. So if I click this to 9, enter, then this will update to PT1000. So here are actually those enumeric values, the, what kind of sensor types you can have. Oops. Yeah. I have the Teams I was actually putting the notification off, but the Teams is still sending me. So I have here the event view, so it will get those off spec. It's the running the simulations, and the history trend view is showing the live values all the time. So it was a small server that actually gives all the functionality here. And also the device topology or network set. Here are the, this is the imaginary, it's just a handmade topology. So that was the short demo. Then we can go back to presentation. Let's try to put that extend mode back. Okay, never mind. So then I have implemented also small condition monitoring web server as a React. So it's actually reading directly the OPC UI, the PADIM server data here. So it shows this device manual, device health, manufacturer, revision counter, serial number, software revision. Everything is actually coming directly from the PADIM server. This is actually now without any styling, but it's actually using React component that will actually, it's the really interactive and the responsive, but that's actually proxy component and that can be licensed from STIR 5. That is, this one is not the production already. This is just a small prototype, but I think this is the what the future will be. So you will have, you can implement the web-based condition monitoring very easily. Okay, and this is then the another example how you can actually use this the Immersal, that is the visual positioning system, because on site we don't have normally the GPS information, but you can actually calculate the position from the photos with this Immersal. And this is now an application that I built, so it's the location aware mobile phone application. So on this left side, you can actually have the, it doesn't have the location now, it has the red star on the left on the icon, and when it gets the location, the icon is green, and then you will get the GPS coordinates there, and the, with GPS coordinates, I can find the device, and then I can actually get from the device the, also the, all the node IDs, the variables. I'm actually reading then the, with the correct hierarchy, the address space, the, all the values, and then I can select which value I want to show. This is now the primary value that is simulated on cloud. I'm running actually the backend on the Amazon AWS EC2 instance, and this is my mobile phone that is now getting the data into this mobile phone display. And what is actually background? Matias, this is interesting. I can also use the Endershauser Ethernet APL device, and it has actually fields for the geolocation. So we can automate that with the different kind to aggregate the information from the device itself. And that's very important when we are going to FX. Then we will get actually the, also into the supporting applications, the, all the information for the device itself. Or we can update with the mobile phone the location back to the device when we are installing, commissioning those devices. That's very interesting future stuff. Okay, and thanks for Etienne, because he has implemented these background SDKs, and then those are available from the GitHub, and that enterprise support is needed, most probably for the development. And those components, some of those need separate license. And this Valmet device server was built with the TypeScript. I'm not sure if I can give the prototype without Valmet bindings or integration out as a source code. That is not yet finally decided. And it can compile with the PKG to executable that will protect your own source code, your own implementation. So, questions? Thank you.